Welcome to the video news of the week. We have updates in two stories we've been covering in recent weeks. 2 weeks ago, we reported that the wind park in Millsfield and Dixville Notch sought to pay only half the taxes that were expected by the Coos County Commissioners when Brookfield Power sent $245,175 in payment of taxes, half of what was expected for last year, with a company saying that it was not allowed to generate as much power as it had hoped. The commissioners protested, and just before February 1st, Brookfield Power relented and came forward with the remaining funds amounting to a total of a payment of $495,000. The three-member Coos County Commissioners Board acts in the same role as the Town Select Board for unincorporated places like Millsfield and Dixville Notch. The commissioners expressed satisfaction that the situation has now been apparently resolved. Meanwhile, the Northumberland Board of Selectmen have ordered that the company handling the demolition of the former Groveton Mill is under orders by the town to stop work. The decision made after last Monday night's Select Board meeting is seen as a move by the town to spur the company, Green Steel, to honor its commitment to the conditions the company promised to fulfill during demolition. Selectman Mike Phillips told us this week that any further demolition at this point would be without official sanction until, as he said, we get certain things resolved. At issue is $20,000 that the company is said to have agreed to deposit in escrow to start the work, which hasn't been seen, as well as an accountability as to where the steel salvaged from the former mill is going. 10% of the funds acquired from the salvage of steel at the plant are supposed to be placed in escrow account, but as the company has submitted no reports, the town is not aware of how much steel has been sold. Phillips told Chronicle reporter Marie Hughes that if conditions aren't met by February 11th, the town would close off Mechanic Street to salvage crews until the impasse can be resolved. You'll find more in this story in this week's Colebrook Chronicle.
The second in the Great Northwoods Vintage Snowmobile Races was held last Saturday. After the rapid snowmelt of the past week, the race, which was to be held in the field behind Northern Tire in Colebrook, had been relocated to Errol. The next race, also in Errol, will be held on the 23rd of this month. A special presentation was held at the Pittsburgh Fire Station on Sunday morning. It stems from a 2010 fatal snowmobile accident which took the life of Gary Lopes of Massachusetts on Pittsburgh Trails. The presentation was given by Dan DeRosa, close friend of the late Lopes. Each year, nearly $1,500 of donations have gone towards the Pittsburgh Police Department, Pittsburgh Fire Department, and local fish and game in his memory.
We can go down almost any road from where we're from, and we can see a sign of Gary Lopes. You know, either his trucks, his family, a ball field, a pavilion, soccer fields. I mean, he was the most, and some of you who know him, that Lopes family is the most giving family I've ever met. We want to keep coming back here at this date and just keep his memory alive. So what better way if we can provide the EMS people with some tools or money that they can get, tools that they need to either save a life or go to emergency. So we have $1,000 for the Pittsburgh firefighters and from the Lopes family and the DeRosa family and friends. So I'll give it to you. Thank you very much for all you do up here. On behalf of me, my family, and Maria and her family and friends, this four cameras for the fishing game.
Thank you.
A large crowd gathered in Sherbrooke last Saturday for the arrival of the 2013 Canada Games torch in its host city. Three athletes who will be participating in the coming games took the torch through town, where nearly 2,000 people awaited its arrival. St. George's Anglican Church in Lennoxville, Quebec has become the home of a brand new, locally made organ. The digital pipe organ includes 92 stops and 4 different keyboards, which allow the organist to make many different sounds. It made its debut during last Sunday's 4 p.m. choral evensong service at the hands of guest organist Leslie Young. The small town of Bury, Quebec came alive with activity during their winter carnival events. Action kicked off in Memorial Park at 9 a.m. at the skating rink with hockey games, broom ball, children's games, and sleigh rides. The day wrapped up with a dance at the Bury Community Center and was deemed a huge success by organizers. The North Country was treated to a concert by international Celtic group Cantrip this past Tuesday. The high-energy show was sponsored by the Great North Woods Committee for the Arts and was held at the Rialto Theatre in downtown Lancaster. Here is some of the footage from the trio's performance.
But you might become the finest glue.
The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. The effects of the nor'easter that has been predicted for areas south of here this weekend will be felt going into Friday, with snow throughout the day. Saturday will clear up a bit in the afternoon, with a high of 15 and a low of -5, and Sunday will bring clear skies, with a high of 24 and a low of 13 degrees. The Colebrook Mohawks played the Pittsburg-Canaan Yellow Jackets last week in girls and boys varsity basketball action.
Get the ball.
Got it!
There you go!
Yeah!
Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.